If you're really lost with the ordinary products or just skincare products in general, I'm here to help you. Today we're talking about the ordinary rosehip oil and how you can apply it and use it and how to incorporate it in your skincare routine. Hey guys, I'm Laura, I'm your French skin educator. For those who don't know me, basically I post videos about skincare tips and knowledge. I want to help you get your skin together, get your ideal skin, help you figure out skincare basically. So the rosehip oil is an oil that's 100% pure rosehip oil, so there's nothing else in it, and it's cold pressed, which is very important because all the good properties of the rosehip oil are kept. Also, the rosehip oil is actually called like that because it comes from little fruits that are right under roses. So let's jump in with the do's and the don'ts of this skincare product. First do, you can use it regardless of your skin type, so it's really for everyone. Whatever your skin type is, go ahead and use it, it's safe. But it's particularly good for acne prone skins and sensitive skins. It actually has a low comedogenicity of 1. So basically comedogenicity is measured on a scale from 0 to 5, so 0 being the non-comedogenic and 5 being the highly comedogenic. So this oil is at 1, so it's very not likely to be comedogenic. This all means that it's very not likely to clog your pores and create breakouts and pimples. It's better for acne prone skins also because of its restorative and healing properties that are due to its high concentration of vitamin A, B1, B2, B3, and vitamin K. I keep saying vitamin because in French we say vitamine, so I'm so sorry. That's what makes it heal your pimples, restore sensitized skin, and it also helps restore and heal acne. There was a fly just right next to me, okay. So it also helps heal and restore acne scars. It helps fade your acne scars. It's rich in vitamin A. Basically, vitamin A is also what gives retinols. You know, retinols are basically vitamin A. I would say it's the best ingredient for fighting acne. I'm not talking about rosehip oil. I'm saying like vitamin A. It's really the best ingredient, better than benzoyl peroxide or salicylic acid, to my opinion. Don't number one, since I said that it's pretty high in vitamin A, I would recommend you that you don't use it the nights you use your retinol. But like if you're using like the retinol from the ordinary, like the 0.2% in squalane, for example, from the ordinary, it's the lowest concentration of retinol. You're not like exposing yourself to too much vitamin A. Like you're not gonna get anything like a rash or sensitized skin. I'm just talking about if you have a very concentrated form of retinoid, because retinoids and retinol is not the same. Retinoids basically is the whole family. Oui? Adema? Oui? Bisous? A French intermission. My parents just told me good night and see you tomorrow and kisses. If you're using very strong forms of retinoids, I would recommend you that you don't use the rosehip oil that night. You just alternating. The nights you don't use your strong retinoids, you can use the rosehip oil. You can use this oil with any active ingredients except the retinoids, like the really strongest forms. But for example, salicylic acid, any AHA, niacinamide, you can really pair it with rosehip oil because you're not gonna mix it though. Okay, because an oil doesn't mix with water-based ingredients. Don't number two is use this magical little bottle as your cleansing oil. Like, do not waste it. Let me explain for you. If you don't even know what are cleansing oils, I made a video on that. I don't know where. Go check it out. It's a perfect video because it's from me, okay? And I explained to you everything about them and I recommend you some of them. So go check it out. But anyways, when you use a cleansing oil, after that, you want to remove it. When you're using this oil, this rosehip oil, as your cleansing oil, it's not going to go away because there's no surfactants that are going to make it foam and, you know, make it be able to rinse
off.
Because water and oils don't mix, it's gonna literally be left on your skin as a film over your face. Now, I don't know if it would make you break out, because as I said, there's a low comedogenicity of one, but you wouldn't have to use just 2 drops of rosehip oil to remove your makeup or your sunscreen or whatever. You would actually have to use at least 1 whole dropper. So that's a lot of oil left on your skin that you can't even take off, and you would actually need a real cleansing oil to take it off. So that's just funny. Like, at the end of the day, it just comes back to you gotta have your cleansing oil and don't play with other oils. And I'm talking about this rosehip oil, but it is true for any rosehip oils, and it is true for any oils that are not formulated to be a cleansing oil. So like, don't start to run to your kitchen and take your olive oil and think you're gonna be able to cleanse your face with that. Because I know a lot of y'all did that. And not a lot of y'all did that, because a lot of y'all heard that from someone that was like, I cleansed my face with an oil, I did oil cleansing, and they just took like castor oil from their cabinet. But it's not gonna do anything, and you're gonna be left with a lot of oil on your face, and it's gonna make you break out. Because these oils though, olive oil, castor oil, all of that, these oils are really comedogenic, so you're definitely gonna get breakouts from that. Okay, just get you a cleansing oil. I made a video on that, but mine, it's actually this one. Calendula Complete Cleansing Oil from iUnique. It's very lightweight, it's very light, it gets everything done. It gets the makeup off, sunscreen off, and then I follow up with a cleanser. I'll put the link in the description box for this cleansing oil and the video about cleansing oils that I made. Do number 3. You can use this oil for mature skin, or if you want like an anti-aging action. As I said, it's high in vitamin A, but it's also high in vitamin C, and both of them are antioxidants that help fight radical damage. They're just protecting your skin from the environment and everything that could hurt your skin or make it age quicker. Get it if you have wrinkles, or if you're fearing premature aging, or if you just want to like be cautious. Honestly, I'm using it because I wanted a facial oil, and I know this rosehip oil is just bomb for everything, for my acne prone skin, and it's kind of like helping me have an anti-aging routine without even having one, you know. Do number 4. If you have hyperpigmentation, girl or boy, use this oil because it helps with it. As I said, it has vitamin C and it has vitamin A. Both of them really help with hyperpigmentation. Like, they help you get rid of acne scars. You can have any type of hyperpigmentation, this oil is gonna help you. It's not gonna be the most dramatic result because it's still an oil at the end of the day. It would be more concentrated if you would get a vitamin C serum, obviously. I'm just recommending this because you can add it on top of ingredients like vitamin C. As I said, it plays well with any skincare ingredients, so you can get the most out of your skincare routine by implementing this oil on top of other serums that are targeting your skin issues like hyperpigmentation or acne or anti-aging, whatever you want. It's just adding a little more concentration of these vitamins or these ingredients that you would need for your skin. Do number 5. Use this oil if you're suffering from rosacea or eczema. It also is rich in vitamin E, and basically vitamin E is not even that exceptional. Like, it's present in all oils because vitamin E is the compounds of oil. You're getting that, but you're also getting other antioxidants in this oil that help heal your skin and restore it. Since rosacea and eczema are basically really sensitized skin, like dry skin, this is bringing healing, restorative properties. It also calms down inflammation. Also, it acts as a shield over your skin, so basically it protects your skin from losing water. That's called transepidermal water loss. Since it's an oil and it's not like a medication, it's not gonna cure this disease, because eczema and rosacea are serious skin issues and you should always be treated by a dermatologist. I'm just saying this could be good to implement in your skincare routine on top of like your topical medications or whatever your dermatologist gave you. Do number 6. You can use this oil morning and night, twice a day, 4 times a day. No, just kidding. You can use it morning or night, morning and night, every day. You really can't, you're safe with this oil. As I said, it's really being well tolerated by most skin types, all skin types. And again, because it can be used with any active ingredients. Don't number three, don't use the oil after your sunscreen. And I would even recommend you to not even use it in the morning. But I just said you can do it, but I'm just, you know, being really cautious. Like, you can do it because it's not gonna hurt your skin. Basically, if you really wanna be very careful, it could potentially not work well with sunscreen. Like, it could make it unstable. The first assumption that's very true and you cannot have any doubt on that has been proven. Don't use the oil after your sunscreen, because the sunscreen should be really the last step of your skincare routine. There shouldn't be anything on top of it, because otherwise it would just reduce the potency of the sunscreen and the UV filters wouldn't work to their full potential, and they would be covered by other ingredients that would reduce their efficiency. The question though is, can you use it under your sunscreen in the morning? I would recommend, to be really safe, that you don't use it in the morning and just at night, because it hasn't been proven, like, definitely, that using an oil under your sunscreen could lower the efficiency, efficacy, effectiveness of your sunscreen. But it could. So since there's a potential, and that sunscreen is really the number one skincare product that you need in your skincare routine, you can't mess with sunscreen. You can't risk making it less efficient. Don't try, don't dare, okay? Don't play with the devil. Don't number four, you can't use it as a moisturizer. Oils and water don't mix. The role of a moisturizer is to hydrate and moisturize your skin. And moisture is from water, okay? So moisturizers are supposed to be water-based. Now, when you say, and a lot of people say that, and I don't even blame people, because brands do that. Brands lie to people by saying that oils moisturize. They even say sometimes oils hydrate. Now, let me explain to you. Oils cannot hydrate, because hydra is coming from the Greek word water. Like, it just, and it said oils and water don't mix. Like, hydrate means there's water in it. There's 100% rosehip oil in this product. It cannot hydrate. There is no water. Okay, so you can't replace your moisturizer by this oil. The thing that your skin needs is moisture, water. It doesn't have it if you're just using the oil. It needs moisture, and it needs it not only on the surface of your skin. It needs it in the deeper layers. That's why water-based moisturizers are the perfect thing, because they penetrate through the layers of your skin. They hydrate. When you're using an oil, first of all, it doesn't moisturize or hydrate it. It nourishes it. Is different. It nourishes it. It's like a lipid, basically. It's fat of it. Oh, I'm just, I spoke French out of nowhere. Like, it's gonna sit on top of your face. It's not gonna penetrate in the deeper layers of your skin. And you know why? Because your skin is water-based, and oils and water don't mix. Like, I know, it's just science. So what you do need to do though, do number seven, is use this oil after your moisturizer. Don't number five. As I said in the niacinamide video that I did, it's also a do's and don'ts. It's also about the ordinary. Basically, one of the things I said is don't use the dropper on your skin. And I'm gonna say it again, because why not? It's also a product that has a dropper. Do not use the dropper directly on your skin. And it's pretty, like, obvious. I mean, I don't know. Some people didn't understand, so I'm gonna clarify it. I'm actually gonna just show you, okay? Don't, like, just put it out. It's very thin, so it's gonna drop if I show you, but don't just put it out and you know, do, like, the influencers, like, run it all on your face and touch your skin with the dropper. What you wanna do, though, is take it out. Okay, don't put it directly on your face. Don't put it directly on your palm, because it's still skin. Just, like, drop it from a distance to your palms. It's not just for this oil. It's not just for oils, for any dropper bottles. Okay, and then what you want to do is just, like, rub it on your palms and then pat on your face. And now, of course, I have makeup, so I can't, but it's also good for your body. But it would be very expensive if you used it on your body. Don't Number six. You saw how shiny my hands were? I just did my whole arms right now. My whole arms with two drops. So imagine your face. Don't use the whole dropper on your face. I personally use like maximum 5 drops, but it's still a lot because I just realized like 2 drops got me a long way. So I might go to 2 drops for my face, but don't use the whole dropper. It's really unnecessary. It's really way too much oil. Just use, I would say, 2 to 5 drops, depending on your face and what you like to feel. Like if you just like to feel like comfortable, or if you really like to feel really glowing, nourished, like you can feel the oil. And since I said it doesn't even penetrate, using a lot will just sit on your face. You know why we need more moisturizer? Because they penetrate on your skin. So you don't have only to think about the surface of your face or your neck. You have to think about the penetration. It's just so crazy. Like you have to use more product because it needs to penetrate. I know, I'm learning at the same time as you, girl. Last one, okay? Do number 8. Do a patch test for this oil. I said it's very well tolerated. It's very well, like it acts very well for any skin type. But for any skincare product, the good thing to do is to do a patch test. You know, I'm gonna just demonstrate it again in front of you because why not? So what you wanna do is you take one on your finger, for example. And you want to put it on a place that has skin that resembles your face. So don't put it on your arm and say like, oh, nothing happened, I can use it on my face. No, it's really not the same skin. This skin is way thicker than the one on your face. So you want to do it like within this range because it's the same skin, kind of. So either do it here, like, you know, somewhere that you can't really see, or you can hide with your hair, like really under your jaw, or you can do it like behind your ear, because you can really hide it with your hair or with anything. If you don't have hair, your ear is gonna hide it for you. Since it's not even an active ingredient, just wait 24 hours and see. If you don't see any difference, then you can use it on your face. You're good. French word of the day. You heard me speak French a little bit earlier. I said, you know what? I'm just gonna talk about this tonight and not even about the French word that I planned to do. I said to my parents, bonne nuit, and it means good night. We don't say like bonne nuit, we say bonne nuit. I said, à demain, see you tomorrow. À demain. Anyways, I hope you learned a lot again tonight. I hope I taught you something and that you now can use this oil and you have all the answers. And of course, if you're still doubting things or if I wasn't clear, comment down below your questions. I, most of the time, like 99% of the time, will answer because I'm good with my community. I hope you're gonna be there for the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and follow me on IG, Twitter, and TikTok. We'll see each other later. Have a blessed week, guys. Love you.